It's Jacqueline. I am so excited that this is my first video on YouTube, and I could not think of a better look to do than a beautiful fall look, because why not? And I hope you enjoyed this video, and please subscribe down below, right down there somewhere, and I hope you like it, so let's go! Hey guys! Alrighty, so first I will start off just by moisturizing my lips, only just with some Vaseline, nothing crazy, and then that way my lipstick will just apply more smoothly, and then next I will be going in with the Smashbox Photo Finish Foundation Primer in Light, and this is the oil-free just because I have a little bit oilier skin, and this just really helps set in your makeup and make it last all day.
She's in the class 18, stuck in her daydream. Been this way since 18, but lately her face seems slowly sinking.
Okay, and next I will be going in with my MAC Pro Longwear Concealer in NC15, along with my MAC Concealing Brush number 287. And I just like to use this concealer on all of my like trouble spots, and with redness all over my face, along with my under eye concealer, which is what most people use that for. So I'm just going in and hitting all of those spots until I get to my eyes.
For angels to fly, no. Ripped gloves, raincoat, try to swim and stay afloat. Dry house, wet clothes. Loose change, banknotes, weary eyes and dry throat. Cool girl, no phone, no. They say.
Alright, so here I am just adding my Pro Longwear Concealer under my eyes in a triangular shape and just patting that in, really ensuring you get that great highlight and cover all those dark circles, and then going in with my Sigma F86 Tapered Kabuki Brush, which I love, and I'm just patting that in, and it's really just sweeping that product back and forth and getting that in there.
Go outside tonight, 'cause in the pipe she'll fly to the motherland and sell love to another man.
And now we are on to the eyes. So first I will go in with my MAC Pro Longwear Paint Pot in the shade Painterly. And this is just kind of like a primer for your eyelids so that your eyeshadow does not crease, especially if you have oily eyelids like me and have that problem. And then your eyeshadow will last a whole lot longer throughout the day. And it's just overall very great.
They say she's in the class 80.
Okay, now going in with the shade Vanilla Bean Makeup Geeks eyeshadow. I am just going to use a concealer brush on this and just pack that all over my lid and just get a really nice, very light brown shade. Just kind of as like a good base when you want to go from dark to light on the eyes.
We don't wanna go outside tonight, 'cause in the pipe we'll fly to the motherland and sell love to another.
Next, I will be going in with my tapered blending brush from Sigma. It's number E40, and I'm gonna take the shade Beaches and Cream from Makeup Geek's line of eyeshadows, and I'm just gonna blend this all out throughout the crease and just buff it out with this brush. And this brush is so great for buffing out all of your colors and ensuring that you won't have any harsh lines, and this just is creating a really nice base color for your eye look. Using that same brush, I'm going to go in with MAC's Soft Brown Eyeshadow, and I'm just going to buff this out on the outer crease, just to get that darker shade in the crease going before we pile on our last color.
And I miss the rush of your skin, and I miss the still of the silence as you breathe out. Walk on water, if I could tell you what's next, make you believe, make you forget. So come on, get higher, loosen my lips, faith and desire, and the swing of your hips, just pull me down hard and drown me in love. So come on, get higher, loosen my lips.
Next, just going in with a random cheap brush that I had laying around, I'm gonna go in with the color Texture from MAC, and I am going to use this as my darkest outer crease color, and it's sort of like a reddish, lighter brown that's just really, really pretty for the fall and to really pop those eyes. Be going in with MAC's brush number 228, which is just a small little smudging brush, and I'm gonna go back in with MAC's Soft Brown and just blend that out on the lower lash line just to make those eyes pop even more so the bottom of your eyes aren't just so white. Now I'm gonna go back to my blending brush and use Vanilla Bean once again and blend out any harsh lines that I might have created up there and just really buff those out. Now it's on to the highlights. So I'm going to use my e.l.f. contour brush, which was probably around $2 to $3 at Target, along with MAC's Shroom eyeshadow. And this is a really great color, especially if you have lighter skin like me, to use as a highlight because it really pops those eyes. I like to use it on the inner corners and bring that up on the lid, as well as right under the brow, and makes a beautiful highlight, and then also in those inner corners and just dragging that down to the lower lash line.
I don't know, but I think I may be falling for you. Dropping so quickly, maybe I should keep this.
Now to make those eyes pop even more, I'm gonna go in with Rimmel London's Scandal Eyes Eyeliner in the shade Nude. And this is just a really great color to put on that waterline on the inside of your eyes. And it really makes your eyes pop and make them look wide awake and a lot bigger. Now I will be going in and doing my eyeliner, and I love using Maybelline's Line Stiletto liquid eyeliner. It has a really nice felt tip to apply a beautiful wing, and what I do is I just go along with the line of my lower lash line and just make a little line straight up, and then connect that down to my upper lid and just fill that in, and it makes a really nice precise wing that you don't have to worry about it being uneven with the other eye. And now it is time for some mascara. I personally enjoy having a coat on my lashes before I even start my makeup, so that way when I go back and my eyeshadow is done, I can just build those up and I don't have to worry about it getting smudged all over my eyeshadow. And this way it just creates really great coats and gives you even more volume than you would when you're applying just your first or second coat.
I'm falling for you.
applying mascara, there's always little smudges that you get on your eyes. So I like to use pointed Q-tips just to get all of the spots off once they have dried. And then after that, I will go back in with just a tiny bit more concealer to get rid of any of the eyeshadow that might have fallen down under the eye. Onto the face, I will be going in with MAC Light Plus Mineralized Skin Finish Powder with my Sigma F80 Flat Kabuki Brush and just buffing out all of that on my face. And I like to use this instead of a foundation just because I have oily skin and sometimes foundations don't look very good on me and they just kind of feel really cakey along with the oil. So using a powder really gives me great coverage and I really enjoy it. And then going in with my Sigma Tapered Highlighter F35 brush, I'm just gonna drag that all along my under eyes as well. Next, I'll begin to contour using my Benefit Hoola Bronzer, and I like to do a contour right on that cheekbone, coming from the top of the ear down, and really buffing that out with this brush so there's no harsh lines, and that you can't tell that it's even there, but it's still sculpting out that cheekbone. And then after I do the cheekbones, I'm going to go up to the forehead and really buff it out along the hairline, and then also bring it down to the temples a little bit after that. And then I will go down to the jawline and really sculpt that out so your whole face just has a really great structure. And then also along the sides of the nose, just to make that nose really defined. And yeah. Then I'm going to put on some blush, and I really like the shade from CoverGirl. I think it's in the shade Rhubarb. I'm not too sure on that, so don't quote me on it, but it's just a really dark, pretty maroony red that just looks gorgeous for fall, especially if you're doing a brown eyeshadow look. Loose change, banknotes, weary eyes, and dry throat. Now I'm going to go and highlight my face. So I'm going to use MAC Mineralized Skin Finish in Soft and Gentle. And this stuff is amazing, let me tell you. I love to use it on the tops of my cheekbones and bring it up to my temples, as well as on the bridge of my nose, the cupid's bow, the chin, and the forehead. And this just gives you a really beautiful glow to your face that makes you look fresh and dewy. And I just love it. Next, I'm going to groom those eyebrows because we all know they need it. And I'm just gonna go through, comb those out, and I don't ever really color in my brows just because I have darker and fuller brows than most people, so I really luck out with that, so I don't have to do that step. But I know if you do that there's some really great brow products out there, and I can still recommend some to you. And now it is time to do the lips. This is a new lipstick out by Jaclyn Hill, who is a YouTuber out here. And this is from Gerard Cosmetics. It's in the shade 1995. Woohoo! And it is a Kylie Jenner inspired lip color, which everyone is talking about, and it is all the rage right now. So this is just a really, really gorgeous mauvey brown shade that looks stunning for any fall look. The worst things in life come free to us. Lastly, I'm just gonna go back in with my Hoola bronzer and just contour under the lip just a little bit to make them look a little bit fuller, kind of like Kylie Jenner's. And then I'm gonna go back in with my nude eyeliner and just line the lips around the edge, really make those lips pop and give it some highlight. For angels to fly. Now Now last, I'm going to go and spray my face, more like douse it, in Urban Decay's D-Slick Makeup Setting Spray. And this is for oil control, and I think it really, really helps. And here we go, the look is complete. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and please subscribe down below, and I will have more videos to come, and I am just so excited to start this channel and get this going, and I figured why not around the holiday season? I'll give you some holiday looks and winter skincare, you know, just all of that, and I can't wait already. Thank you so much, guys. See you later.
Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions
of my heart. All right, so thanks for
why are we here and where do we go? And knock on my soul hard.
Are just trained to cut and color better, but to listen better too, so you can trust you'll get a look you love and leave feeling fabulous every time. Cost Cutters, love your cut.
I woke up on the roof with my brothers,
in a well, in a pool
with my mother.